Welcome after very long time to a new part of story about smradoch 1.0, and we have some issues on the car. We have a lot of issues. There was a trouble with the fan, air fan to the cabin, which was full of ice because car is parked now a little bit angled to the right, and the water went. There is a channel inside the dashboard, not inside the front of the dashboard. It's hidden channel where are motors for maybe only one motor for wipers. And there is also entry point to the cabin for the air. And there are some holes that should lead the water out from this channel, but they are probably close by dirt. And they also could be frozen at this time outside, and the fan was full of water and it didn't move. After a while it started to move. I had to use my hand and turn it a little bit. It started to move, and now I am using the night ventilation mode, which is special feature that I add to the car with the auxiliary battery that is powered from solar panel. You can see it on the roof. It switched to the this fan to the special power source, which is giving about 3 volts or so, and it keep the fan rotating very slowly, and it really prevented to frozen it. Maybe it's also because it's not snowing these days and there is no water in the channel. I don't know, but the today task is to open the brakes and check what causing that the wheel is not rotating freely. I don't know, it's the same on the both side because the differential has locking feature, and it does not allow you to rotate freely each wheel. I need probably 19. So I need, I need 21. This is crazy size. 22 is too big. 21 is not common. I had to buy special nut for it. Okay. And I have this cable here. No, I don't want to use it because it's too long and too thin, and it will probably do nothing with the bolts outside. I'll check if it is full power. Yes. Yeah, but it's almost not moving. Just because I precisely set the torque of the bolt, so it is possible to get it out. If I switch the wheel in the some garage, not mine, but some commercial garage, it will not be able to release it, because they usually don't measure torque. They just try to... Oh, no, it's not good. I will need new drum very soon. It still has some metal parts, but it's disappearing very quickly. Everything has to be black because I have been driving about 30-40 kilometers with locked brake, so it must be full of schmooth. And I have one clever solution to it. And I saw about some box which will catch the dirt and when I will wash it with some thinner before I have to buy some. Before I need better. Yeah, not this small one. This small one is good if you want to remove the paint or so, but not the big one. But the big one, why there is not connected charger? I was too lazy to do it. So I have to find some rest of iron. Oh no. It's not good. Yeah, it's not good. I know it. I have to add some plates to the frame to keep this car running. Because I want some these mechanical parts soon to clean them. But I need more this stuff because just getting wet, not cleaning. Oh no. And we have still some, but I need to buy, and I will need to buy the big. This big box, because it seems I'm able to consume it very quickly. Because I'm splitting everywhere and always. Seems it's just one. No, it's still about several liters of this in the box. And I will need also compressed air to remove it later. And I will clean also this part, which is, I will then lubricate it with the new lubrication, because okay. I'm not sure if I want to remove the brake pads. Because of the cable is somewhere here. It looks still okay. There is still some
Teflon tube or what it is, I don't know. Quite it's possible to see the black paint. No, don't go.
That I unwanted to all
parts wet because it does not make the smoke all around the garage. It produces some smoke, but not so big. I will try to pull the and break. It would be nice if I have some one inside the car. Yes, I don't know if it is. Yeah, it's pull. It's working. It seems it's working. Yeah, it's definitely working. So if it was stuck, it's just a wrong alignment. You can see the new cable, and it's this old one is. I will lubricate it in the bottom. I will lubricate this piece. I don't have any good I have this grease in the injection. It would be good to use. I think it's this one. I'm not sure if it is the issue that it is not. It's quite new. I think it's not this issue. I will pull it up. Yeah, it's moving easily. It's not an issue. But anyway, it would be nice to have this moving freely. So this side is moving. I can add some to the cable, because there is the part where is the cable sliding over something. And here it is. Okay, there is a spring which is not very well fit. I will add also this point. Let's try to move it. I don't see many grease. Yeah, it's not taking too much grease. The problem is also is the spring. This is not good, and there should be some washer. But if there is no washer from the manufacturer, I cannot add it because it's closed solution. There is end which you can cannot disassemble, and if there is no, yes, and this spring is not very strong anyway, I will lubricate this because it can be one point of problem, and then there is the point where the line is broken. In this point, probably somewhere here, is also there is some, I don't know where this is. There definitely is a place where it is not. Maybe it's still connected, it's just spring. That spring is springing. Yeah, but this car will not live forever. You can see that the differential, how it is rusty. It can easily get the hole in two. Because it's, I don't know, it's better to not to touch. It's still working. There is no way to stop this rust. I can only sand everything and paint with new paint, but would work. But with 50% probability that will not, because it cannot be sent so much that
I will try to add
and that grease to the point of entry. To get into the channel, because the left one was just stuck in this point when it comes from the cable to one click is free, and the point when the cable came, yeah, it was already moved somewhere else. I will put it back. It's too much grease at one moment. On the side. So if I move the cable a little bit this way and this way, it does not go back, so we are probably on the end. I will try to move it by hand. Not possible. So it is, if it was stuck, it can be also this issue of this caliper, or what is it? Yes, pistons. These pistons can be frozen, maybe because there is the water in instead of brake fluid. Let's check it. I'm not moving this side. And battery is moving very, very quickly. You cannot catch it. This battery is so quick. So let's test it on the other side. Yeah, there is a free movement on this side, but not on this side, so it's probably the issue. There is no issue with the handbrake. There is an issue with the brakes. So what I can do, I can check what's inside.
It does not look very bad. I can clean it, close the eyes. Yeah, these rubber boots definitely does not do their job. Because on this side there is probably leaking fluid because it's wet. I don't know what kind of wet it is. I don't know. And I will try to clean it with the thinner. And on the other side I will just move it back and forth. Now I don't need this big one. I need small one. And we will see if it is possible to make it move again. So let's clean this side first. Okay, I'm completely. I wash my hands too. It works well. Yeah, it would be big improvement if I buy new pistons and cylinder and everything. It must be the cheapest solution. Most durable solution. Because if I get this piston moving, I have no warranty that it will stop moving next week. Maybe I will push it into and I will never get it back. You will see. I should at first lubricate it with some kind of. Maybe I should open it, but it will. And I have some special grease for brakes, which should be somewhere here. I cannot feel it. It's not here. Where it is, I need some light. If it is rusty and it is partially aluminium, partially. No, this was not the right one. I cannot get to this place because it's this crazy. Well, there was a grease with black, no, blue tube with the Bosch. I blown it. It's not here. That should be on the wall. And the wall is at the floor. There is some weapon,
but not the grease. Where it is? I really do not know. It's
here. I am blind. Okay. I will first put this one. This is some thin oil, which can get into it easily. And then we will solve the lubrication. And what is this? It's not moving at all. It's not moving at all, and I will have to probably. Oh, it's so rusty. This shouldn't be rusty because it's not steel, but anyway, it looks like it is rusty. I don't mean the bleeding valve, I mean the tube. Okay, what's. There is two M10 bolts. One more thing I can do, I will just move these pads somehow to the right. Because left is still working very nicely, I can close it for a while and I can completely remove that rubber piece. I can turn it a little bit, try to turn it. Maybe I can give a kick with a small hammer. It helps to release it. Yeah, it's moving. It's moving. It's good. Now it will be able to turn. Yes, so I can pull it back, but I really push out these jaws. I don't know if it's possible to do it with these pliers. Probably yes. I hope it will not go back. Can easily pull it out and back and out and back. It will probably not be well very tight anymore, but let's wash it. And oh, this is a temporary solution for this winter because I don't drive this car too much. It was staying on the parking place for 2 months. Maybe I was one or two time in the woods this autumn, and not this one. And I was one time when driving to the lunch. To the hospital, but yeah, definitely there is. I don't know if there is the washer on or seal on this piston, or there is the one piece seal on the behind it. Probably it's behind it, and in this case.
I could be able to remove it completely without losing the pressure. And I will try it to invent to move it even more, but it's not possible. Because these brakes are not designed to be this. Yeah, there is definitely the seal on the piston, because and there was, I think there was an air when I remove it. I feel the air escaping. Okay, but it's very loose, and now just use Bosch brake grease to over grease everything. Yes, there is probably already escaping the fluid. Let's move this back. I don't know if I should. Bleed these brakes, and we'll see. It seems there must be air, because it's too springy. There should not be such fast movement back, because if there is the fluid, it will take time to get back to the pipes. I hope you see something, because the camera always goes somewhere that I don't want. I will add some grease to this side too. Yeah, this is dirty solution, but if you want to repair brakes, don't do it this way. This is not a guide. This is just the record, just the lock or the block or the block. How we fix this one. But most important thing is that if the brakes are working, not how they were fixed. If there is leakage, okay, it will be visible soon or later. I will try to bleed it a little bit. Let's move the light to this position. It's probably, I don't know why they have these rubber pieces which are after 2 years like a stone, so you can try to prevent from the rust on the end of the bolt. But there is no chance to close the hole, because the bolt is, no, or the cover is after 1 year completely out of order. So I will use number 10 probably. Most likely it's number 10. We'll see. Yeah, it's definitely 10, but I don't need this one. There are another ones for for brakes. This is 10.
Not for brakes, but for bolts that are quite longer.
Okay. Yes, number 10 is exactly what we need. If you think I am trying to push it wrong way, it's right, because before you release the bolt, I usually try to tighten it even more. And it's a strange idea. It usually works. If you try to, sometimes you cannot release it, and you can tighten it even more. And if so, you can then release it. I will release it a little bit, so there was already fluid in the output. And now I need special bolt for... I need only 10, flat 10, but I have special one. I don't see it here. But there is no pipe, so I don't need this. But it's better, because if it fits, it does not make so big damage, because it's six sides and not 12. What I'm searching for is the bottle, is the some tubes for the fluid. I have been using it on the Volvo, but for the different fluid, and I don't, but the tube is the same one. It was at the end with silicone piece, which was sealed very good on that rusty bolts. And there was some, maybe it's outside, there was some tin, not tin, can, tin can, ah, tin can. It was not made from the tin, but some can it was. Maybe it's outside, I will check it. No, it's not. Not. It was wrong idea. I got a huge cold spray, and now I don't even know where it can be. It's not here. It's not here. It's not here. It must be somewhere. Somewhere there is a box that should not be on the ground. I don't know if it is not under Volvo, that I don't know where it can be. I should stop recording. It usually helps when I stop recording. I am able to find it very quickly. It was not so quick as I expected. And in the meantime, before I clean the hose, because it's completely wet of silicone brake fluid, I show you these white strange parts, which are the holders for the snorkel. These will be holding it on the cabin. These are to the middle. This one is angled for this last one, and this one is damaged a little bit. So I have the tube or hose or whatever, and let's try to bleed it just as is, without using. Pedal, because it should go out just by the gravity. No. It don't go out. I need some clip for keeping the hose in the so it doesn't go out easily. I don't know if you see it. So I will press the pedal and we will see what's happened.
Yeah, one more thing I have to do is to make new hinges for this door, because this is getting so long. Maybe I should use the drum. Because, yeah, but it went out. It's
black, completely black. I need to use the drum for keeping the brakes inside, not to. I'm just trying to make it free, because I don't know, maybe I should a little bit move this. Yeah, this should be definitely lubricated. And I should move it back a little bit. And this works. So it will move. It does not move at all, because it does not work. Why it is not moving? That's another story. These crazy aligning, self-alignment, self-setting devices, which usually does not work, and these lights are not able to light where I want. Mm-hmm. I need to pull it a little bit more out. It's pulling together. It's not good, but I see the wheel. It's not moving. It's bad. It's not moving even back. Yeah, I was able to move it one step back. One step forward. If I'm moving it right now, yeah, probably. And this should be able to pull it. It must go very easily. Yeah, this is. Turns whole unit, and use this more liquid lubricant. It's not good at all. This spring should, this small piece should be able to turn it, but I see I am bending my screwdriver, that it definitely will not work. Okay, now I've need to go back. I need some pliers. I will remove that spring part. That's I remove this spring, if it is possible. It's quite strong. I should not remove it from the. It was what I don't want to do, because I don't want. It's probably here. Yeah, it's crazy to put it back, I know it. So I put this down. It does not go down because it goes down only if it is pressed out. Yeah, there is a space between the. It's still not in this. I know I'm damaging the rubber part, probably. Not the rubber part of the pliers, but the rubber part of the. Rubber part of the. That boot. This should go down. Yeah, it works. It works if it is not under pressure. Under pressure. Under pressure. So, but now I have to put it back because I turn it so much. So how I will do this? I don't know. I need some how to make it freely moving, and I need some expanding things. I will use this wood. This is nice, but I don't get to that piece of bottom. No, I don't need such big one. I need some flat bar, which just fits into the space, and I can move it. This is not. But this could be. Yeah. Okay, this is what I need for a little bit prevention of damaging that rubber part. Now I have to put this piece of steel. No. It's not good. I need something more sophisticated. I know what I know, what I need. But I will definitely. I don't have light. I have light. Okay. And now I will turn it back. easily, but the other side it's opposite type of screw. I will have to make it smaller, so I have to turn it up. Okay, it goes quite freely and it seems now it's, yeah, there is, we'll see. Yeah, I will check it if it works. You will see it. After I will win this fight, I will. Now I am moving it more. No, I don't need the light. I need this piece go out, and I will turn it very much to the clock. Okay, I hope it's too way too far. We will step on the brake several times and we will see how it works. And now I need the spring. It was on the ground, or I give it somewhere else. I remember it was it was on the ground, but my light was more clever than me. Now I have to fix it into this hole. Yeah, it was quite easy. And now I have to hold it a little longer. No. Don't go away. Okay. Another try, and these pliers are quite weak. They are just for getting something which fall down, and even not for this. You need some screwdriver to get it out. And maybe I will need compressed air. This is also a solution. Still here. It's out. Okay, next try. And it's the same pliers. Let's find the hole. Okay. Hold it very tightly. It's on. So now each push. In meantime, we lost a lot of fluid, so we are now quite yellow. And I expect we are out of any bubbles. And now you can see it's really free, and at first I will find some fluid. I think it is the last one, is this big one. There is some dot four, but it's probably, yeah, it's a waste one. This is for the bed. But one which was removed from the car, and we have to fill this new one
first, I hope. We are still not run into dry here, because still enough. Because if we have empty here, we will have big troubles. This is really tricky part. It never worked. It always ends with the fluid everywhere. And I must be quick, because this fluid does not like anything, and it can damage everything, every paint, every. Okay, we are full.
I have to find another way how to use this bottle.
Maybe I should. Maybe I can get some balloon with the sucking pipe or whatever. Okay, it's time to step on the brakes. And No, I wanted to mark that wheel, if it is moving, but it will definitely move, because we will find that there is 2 times more thread turns visible than that now. Pedal is going a little bit deep. Yeah, the sounds you probably don't hear. Maybe you can hear it. It means that it is moving. It is moving for long distance, and strange clicking noises means that it trying to turn that wheel. These things really works if they are new or if they are almost new. But after 20, more than 20 years, it's hard to find a new part. It's not easy to, it's not possible to buy it on the aftermarket. Maybe if I ask the Nissan, they will have this spare part, but we have to live with the original one and keep it working, if it is possible. Pedal is now going like normal. It means almost no way, like without started engine. I cannot almost push it. It means that the self-alignment thingy really works, and it quite fast. I will check the handbrake. Yeah, it also, you can see that it is moving. Definitely it was not issue of a handbrake, It's good that I didn't buy that the cable right now when I found that the wheel is hot, because in case I was too fast, I have to change the I can still little bit tight it, because first click has a free play, but it's good, because we know that if the first click is, we know that something can get longer, shorter, and it will never be stopped by handbrake so let's check it. No, I think it was two turns, not more, maybe. And there is one more thing to do, is to bend this little bit and then bend on this part to allow. I would like to see it working. We can see it working. It's not so. It works when the piston pushed more than the piston move it more than the bar is able to. I need to grab both sides. Maybe I can show you how it works. I don't know if it is visible. You have to watch this wheel, but it is not probably visible from this side. I even see it very small, very not very good. And if it's beginning to work. If these parts go more, you can see it move it for a one click. I will not do it more times, because if I do it more times, it will get stuck. I didn't want to use it, so I tried to everything to avoid this, because it will damage it, it will get dirty. But I don't have any such big chunk of steel, so I have to use aluminium. Anyway, it's stuff for some construction work, and it does not need to be nice, shiny, and so. So let's disconnect the pipe or the hose or whatever. It's good that we get yellow. Yeah, you can see. I don't know if you can see it. No, you cannot see it. It was dark, and when I let the hose to get empty, it was yellow around it. And it's good we get out that black stuff. It cannot be called brake fluid anymore. It's just the black stuff. And this is the hose. It needs to be cleaned because I use it for I will use it for Volvo, which use different kind of fluid. And one more thing is that these rubber closure, yeah, it's fit, but it's loose. It's do not want it anymore. Yeah. Each time you bleeding the brakes, you have to use a new one because it makes no sense to. I fill it with this and this
special grease. Okay.
Maybe it's getting firm because of there is always a little bit little amount of the brake fluid, and it cause the rubber getting firm. What I also do, I will try that if I tight it well with the flat key, I will try the wrong one, and I will spray around this stuff. It's based on lanolin, and it really works somehow sometimes. If it makes some firm cover, it works. So we have one part of today's mission finished. What's the time? In normal way, I would say we have about 30 minutes left to do other stuff. Now, because I am alone, I don't need to be at 6 at home. Fuck. I can work even more. It seems it's pretty clean inside, and let's put the wheel back, and I will show you how I use that torque key for tightening the wheel nuts. Oh my pants. I always they are still broke something, but still not opening between the legs. It's good. I forgot something? No, probably not. Yes, usually I don't put the nuts on the manually, but this car has some kind strange the beginning of the nuts. Some of them goes very badly on the thread, and so I rather better to do it by hand than. This is not good. Maybe. And now I take the special device, use a red one, and tight it. Oh no, I need to break. You check if the handbrake is working. And now I just use one hand. On this length. And try to tight as much as I can. Yes. And it's done. And now we can put the car down, because it's hard to do the, yeah, you can see the winter tires. It's a Capelita, it's a Capelita LT or what? It was bought as a Capelita LT light track, and there's a sport utility. I don't know, it's the, and there is no, it's great for the winter, but it's too narrow, because I bought these because of 215 is the legal size, and these are only legal size I have, and it's good, but for the driving out of the street I will use definitely wider ones like these. I have wider rims, 1, 2, 3, 4. I can swap the spare wheels for winter ones, but makes no sense. I'm driving so less in the winter, so even in the summer, so having new set of winter wheels is not what I learned. Oh, I save two. Maybe I save all of them, because they can be reused. And if they are full, just burn it. That's all. Carco can go down. Yes, definitely. I will check the how the steering works, because there was some issues with this joint, or with this lever. I made new bushings for it. It was quite loose, but now it's okay. Let's go down. I don't know if the yeah, definitely there is. Second today task is quite tricky. I had to have to find there must be remove this ball, because yeah, I will have to use some sealings to prevent water in going into snorkel. That's one way, and into car. For these two, I need just seal that screw against the, because if I am under the water, I don't want to suck the air, the water into snorkel. So drilling the hole inside is completely insane. Yeah. But I don't want any bad looking holders. I want to cover it with the blue paint, and it will be easy because it's already quite damaged from the sun, and that's all. Also, I had some cover for this around. I don't have it anymore. I will need to clean this rubber stuff. I don't know what. Maybe I can take a silicone and close it. Anyway, what I need to do is to find the place where I need to drill from the outside. So I have to make some template which I slide on the pipe. I will drill the hole on the one side, and I will get out on the other side in right place. Maybe it's too much complicated. Maybe I just can drill the hole and it's all. What's more, I have to do is to, after drilling this hole, disassemble that snorkel, and I have to put middle part into the pipe. Maybe I should do it without overthinking. I will take 8 millimeters drill bit and just look at it, 7.758. Look at it and go for it. I will need M5, some long bolt. I probably already bought some, these long ones. I hope they are enough long. I need M8 washer, but I still did not manage to buy. No, this is not the right one. But I can use this one for nut and washers, and the second one, which is not here, where it is. It must be somewhere here. And this one I can use just for the bolts, but I lose the box. I'll use this big one. I lose the box for the stainless steel wood screws, so I don't know what's better. Yeah, it's bent somehow, this nylon printing. What's another one? Let's check all of them. It's much better, because I will start with this one. No, probably I will not start with this, because it needs to be... Yeah, it's designed not to be free. And this one is, this was damaged during printing and it's not possible to even. I think it's, yeah, I can. Yeah, without battery, this thing does very low work. Edges are quite out of axis. Okay, let's try it. And just take an eye on it because it was already marked with these strips, so it's not so difficult, and I want this horizontally, so even if I not horizontally, I want it a little bit, I don't know if it is upward, probably this way. Let's try it. Not impact. Can I? No impact. And now I want to check where is the... little below. And now I have to find that pieces. Where they go? One is here. This is the top one. And the middle one is where? There was the middle one. Yeah, it's this middle one is here, and bottom one should be somewhere. Yeah, I see it. I am too down. But yeah, it will work somehow. I can turn the one thing is that I can turn that pipe, and one more thing I have to do is to remove this pipe. I don't know if it is still possible. It must be possible. This. Okay. It's first time after several years of using that I am trying to disassemble. I am trying this one because I want to put that piece to it, but I don't know if it is possible from this. I am not exactly in the middle. It looks I am a little bit down. Not working this way. Yeah, this is. Is this water? Yes. It must be water because it's getting water from outside. From the... This is crazy because it's not aligned with the... This is the only one point where I was not very good, and this was because of this part and this part. It was not able to, not not possible to give it right way. So I am a little too down. I will try to. Maybe I should drill it out of. I will keep it right now, but I'm not very happy with this. And then when I have, I don't know where is that. Yeah, in my pocket. It's designed to be able to pull it with one hand to the desired position. Yes. Pull the hand out. Yes. It's not mandatory to pull out the hand. And then, yes, I forgot to add the washer. The washer will be, is now, this is temporary solution for the winter. I will buy new pipes and I will do it better later. Which one? This one. Yeah, this should be. But the bolt is short. The bolt is definitely short. Yes. I don't need. I cannot use the washer. Or I can. I have to use longer bolts. I have to use probably some not bolt but thread rod. And if I have stainless M8, I should have. I have. And I will use. I didn't want to use this. It's doesn't looking good because it's too sticky. I want to use flat one with some special. I wanted to use. Imbus or as you call it Allen key, but they do not produce this one so long. I will check it. This is too short. I need to have it about 1 centimeter longer. Let's cut it. Yeah, we are definitely near the battery end, so you have to be prepared that any time the battery can die. And now I'm making the stamp on the last one. And these two was not very successfully. And this one was very successfully drilled, because first one is quite below the middle. This is middle, but it's somehow angled this way, but it's not issue. Maybe it's even better. But I started drilling from the other side, and I went out a little bit higher, and I have to turn the tube. That it's not better, because now I get the clean part to the top, and the clean part is not what I wanted to have. I wanted this badly scratched to spray it. Anyway, I think I will buy new pipes, and I will switch them very soon. There another issue is that it's not possible to get it out if the nut is if not release. This is the only way. I will damage the thread, but this nut doesn't matter, because it's in the middle, and there will be no nuts on it. And maybe I will do new bolts. I will just weld some special head on it, and maybe I will take a Allen screw and extend it. It's also solution. Yeah, it's already free. And yeah, it's maybe the best solution, because it's and my finger is not holding anymore, and turning this is not the way to pull it out. I don't know why. It's well lubricated. I think that what works is the doesn't matter really what you can see inside. This one is in opposite direction, because there is the joint exactly behind, and I need to find the point of drilling, and I think I have it, but I will go to the metal light. Yes. It's hard to say. I have to check the opposite piece, because it was this way. No, it was this way. This way. How it was? It must be this way. Yeah, there is the power piece of paint. Let's try to align it the same way as it was. So I have to do it in this point. And as I said, battery is almost empty, and I will drill the hole into. Then I put it back, and I will try to keep the angle. If it is possible to drill the hole. No, it's not possible. I don't have enough long drill. Maybe if I just I will probably able to.
Battery slow.
Do not have so much time because battery is almost dead. I will show you how it ends. It's now fixed. It was very tricky because I was always wrong with the drilling angle and drilling position, and finally I could fit it. So that's all for today, and I hope you enjoyed the video. And if there is some other repair of this old crappy car, I will record it, and I hope you will watch it again. But it would be better for me if no other repair will come. So that's all for today. See you in some next video, and that's all. Goodbye. Yeah, it is a little bit visible on the top because probably different position than earlier, but still quite okay. That's all. If you want to see it from other side, all I think I need to do is paint it to the blue. Maybe I should paint onto this part. That's all.
Battery is low.